Wasn't that good? Can always count on you.
Amen.
So we can always count.
I'm just counting you too, brother.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Before I close this out, I just want to share something real quick. Brother Wayne, you spoke about God and the people that blame God for all of their woes and all of their worries and all of their disappointments in life and all of that. You know, it's so true. You know, all of you heard my testimony. I was one of those people that blamed God for everything that was happening to me in my life. And, you know, when I learned that once I got saved, that, you know, I had to look at God, you know, from this perspective. And then I had to reflect back on those times when I was blaming him and understand, you know, that God, I knew there was God, you know, but God was hidden, and at least I hid him from me. It was a part of me that just would not let me accept the fact that what was going on in my life didn't have anything to do with God. I had no one to teach me any different. I needed to blame somebody. So I could only think of the one person that had the power to do something about it. And then when he didn't, you know, it took me 40 years to realize why he didn't. He never did anything about it because I never asked him. You know, all I did was blame him for 40 years of my life. You know, why has this happened to me? Why has this happened to me? You know, why am I going through this? You know, why did I have to get sick? Why did I have to be dealing with depression? Why did I, you know, just everything that was wrong in my life, I blamed him for it. And in doing that whole time, especially in my youngest years, you know, when I first began to get sick, when I was around 10 years old, you know, of course, you know, to cope with things, you know, I started abusing alcohol at a very early age. I turned everything that I could get my hands on, you know, and I made sure that I would stay out of his way. At least I thought I was staying out of his way. So what I didn't realize was that throughout my childhood, going into my preteens and my teens, I have lost friends, very best friends, just constantly, car wrecks, gunshots, you know, things of that nature. And I couldn't understand, you know, why was I still here? You know, God was doing things for me on my behalf, but I was too sick and too messed up and too angry to see it. Even though I couldn't see it, there was something that was always inside of me that would not let me, you know, do the things that, you know, I was inspired to be a true hula. I was born. That's what I was inspired to be. Now, I was well on my way. But there was things along that path that hoodlums do that I just could not do. And I knew there was something greater than me that wouldn't allow me to take someone's life, to carry a gun. I was doing everything else, but those were the things that I just could not and did not want to do. But I knew that it was something greater than me. It was always something that I knew that was keeping me out of harm's way. You know, when my friends were getting killed and I wasn't. But it wasn't until, you know, I gave my life to Christ here that God made it clear to me. Like Brother Wayne said, we all have a testimony. You know, I realized the things that I was going through, he allowed me to go through them, but he wasn't the cause of it. But he allowed me to go through those things so that I could stand here, or stand out there on that corner, or stand, you know, somewhere, you know, and tell anybody who would listen, you know, what God did for me in my life. And to know what my purpose is in life, I can't think of anything more rewarding, you know, as a Christian today, you know, to be a living testimony. You know, God gave me purpose. You know, he kept me here for a reason, and that's the reason why I'm here. You know, to tell anybody who would hear me, if God can get me out of the mess and out of the stuff that I was in, that I was doing, and get me to this point, and it's not because I loved him, it was because he loved me. He always loved me, I just didn't know it. He loved me when I was bootlegging, he loved me when I was selling drugs, and using drugs, and abusing drugs. You know, he always loved me, but I just couldn't see it. But it's so clear to me now. And God is so great. So much patience, you know, that he waited 40 years for me to say I'm sorry, you know, to ask for forgiveness so he could change me. And it's amazing. Who else could do that? It's nobody. It's only one. It's only one could do that for me or anybody else. So I thank God, you know, for making me a witness and providing me with a story to tell, with a testimony to tell, because I couldn't tell it if I never received it, because I would have been, along with the rest of my friends and a lot of other people, I'd have been dead and gone and nobody never knew who I was. But God had a purpose for me, and I found that purpose, and I'm using that purpose, you know, to speak into other people's lives and to show them that we do have a God, you know, and a mighty God, and a God that's unlimited with his love and with his mercy and with his grace, and that is nothing that he won't do for me or you if you humble yourself and come before him and ask, and ask. And he will do it. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right. I'll close this out with a quick prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Father, for the wonderful, wonderful message that Brother Wayne brought to us tonight. Father, he is so anointed. We thank you, Lord, for being in the midst of us. We thank you for everyone that's here tonight. Father God, bless them. Keep them well. Keep them safe. Watch over their loved ones, their entire families, their possessions. Father, everything that you're doing in our lives, continue to do those things. We know you will. God, we thank you. Watch over our pastor and our pastors. Watch over this church and everything that this church stands for. Father God, continue to help us and support us and keep us lifted up. Father, there is no other love like your love. We thank you for your son. We thank you, Father, for everything you're doing in our lives, from the past to the present and to the future. We love you, Lord. We give you praise, we give you glory, and we give you honor. In Jesus' name, amen.